You are listening to the Built to Grow Podcast.
All right, welcome back to the Built to Grow Podcast. I'm your host, Tim Lyons, in studio, Scottsdale, joined by, as always, by Randy Engston. What's up, man?
Hey, buddy.
Doing good?
Doing great.
Got some good stuff to talk to you all about today. In fact, this whole episode is going to be about, you know, the Black Friday offer and how to position it and what you're going to do this year. This is it's time to take action. What are we, October? I don't know when when does this episode come out?
What day is today? 2nd? 1st. It's 1 week from today.
So the 7th.
7th.
Yeah.
No.
8th.
8th. Because that's a Wednesday.
Okay. So it's October 8th. You're listening to this right now. That means you have about, 2 months, a month and a half to Black Friday.
Yeah, till Black Friday itself, okay. Sure.
So Black Friday, what is it? Why is it called Black Friday? You know, what's the whole point? Well, years ago, I don't even know when, the story is, you know, retailers had to create some massive sales to basically get their businesses profitable in one swoop. And if you guys look at the P&L, red numbers negative numbers are red and positive numbers are black. And in order to get to the positive, you had to sell a bunch, and that's where the term Black Friday
comes from.
Black Friday. That's when it comes, we can get profitable in our businesses. And this year, I think it's a special year. We've touched on this a couple episodes ago. We've also done one last year around this. It's just such a good time to make money, to make sales, because of the condition of the prospect.
The buyer.
Buyer, sure. Yes. So think about, it's funny, women and men are very different when it comes to buying and why they buy. I mean, obviously it crosses over, but if you look at men, we buy things maybe too expensive because we need something.
Sure.
And women buy things that they don't need because it's a great deal. Yeah. It happens in my household constantly. I see boxes of Amazon at the door. Every night I go home, there's a pile of boxes. I got to get through the boxes just to get to the front door. What are in the boxes? And the justification comes from my wife is, well, it was a great deal. You know, we'll use it
eventually.
Yeah. and I'm like, don't buy it if you don't need it. And that's my mentality. If I need it, I'll buy it. If I don't need it, I'm not going to buy it. So it's just this weird thing. But when it comes to Black Friday, the people are ready to spend money.
Yeah.
They're preconditioned to spend money. Of all the times of the year, that's the time of the year people are ready and willing to just spend.
People will wait on the things they need for Black Friday. That's how big of this time of year is for discounts and for retailers to push kind of whatever they have available type of thing.
Yep.
I mean, think about it, like the people that pick up the TV or like the large
purchases.
Things that are kind of over the top that nobody quite frankly probably needs, but because they are a great deal, everybody justifies, you know. Yeah. I mean, who doesn't need a 95-inch TV for $200?
I do.
Yeah. I've seen that wall.
Yeah, things sweet, by the way. So if we know this, and we're business owners, why aren't we getting ahead of it?
Exactly.
And so this is your flare somebody that shoots a flare up in the air. That's kind of like your warning, okay? This is your warning. It's time to get ready. Good news is we're hosting a Black Friday workshop where we're going to handle this entire bad boy campaign. If you're a Keep user, we're going to drop this right in your account. If you're not a Keep user, talk to us. We've got a special link to hook you up with. But our Black Friday workshop, we did this last year. And last year, we were a little bit at a disadvantage because we only had email to work with.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so we only had email to work with. We didn't really use text messaging back last year, and we didn't use voicemail broadcast, and those are the things we're going to build into our Black Friday campaign this year through Keep. Okay, so if you're hearing this, you heard me just say Keep. Do not go to their website and go purchase Keep, because you're going to get burned by the pricing. I can get you a much better deal. We're Keep certified partners. If you're looking at us on YouTube, you can see I've got the Keep gear on.
I've got Keep socks on right now.
Yeah,
guys.
Keep socks. So we're really tight with that company, and
there's a reason.
It's a great product, and they're right down the street. So, which is really cool. So that being said, let's talk about the buyer right now, the person that's got, you know, maybe so much money to spend. Mm-hmm. Okay, so talk us through that.
Well, I mean, it's the one time a year where we're coming into the holiday season as well. You know, the family gifts need to happen, friends, family, the dog, everybody needs to be accounted for, right? So as we were talking kind of prefacing why we think this year is going to be different than other years in the past, we have to be ahead of that if we want to, you know, compete. And it's, you know, guys, we don't have a very easy sell in the first place. You know, we know it, right? Picking fitness was not like, you know, we're not, even though it's something that we know everybody truly needs, mm-hmm. it's not always the easiest of sales. So with that in the play as well, you know, you have to, we have to be prepared and we have to be on the front end. We have to be one of the almost first to market, in my opinion, if we want to stand a chance against, you know, the Black Friday deals when it comes to the entertainment and you know, the electronics and all of these big shocking discounts that people, I mean, they just gravitate towards. People knock each other out in grocery, in stores. You've seen it. You know what I mean? It. People are fighting for electronics. I mean, it's ridiculous. So consider ourselves in that mix. How are we going to win there, right?
Yeah, and if you think about it, people only have so much money to spend, mm-hmm. and if they spend it on all these other things because the marketing got to them first, well, they don't have enough money to then maybe buy your personal training program.
Despite how much they want it or quote-unquote need it, once that money's gone, it's gone.
Right. So one of the things I'm warning everybody this year is we got to get out a little bit early, okay? We were thinking maybe early November. I think if we're at least a week before Black Friday, with our open, we call it open cart, a cart's opening, probably running, instead of running the sale for 3 days, we'll probably run it for 10 days. Mm-hmm. So we'll be out in front of it by a week, and then we'll run it through Cyber Monday, will end, and then we'll switch offers. And that's another thing about our Black Friday campaign is we auto switched the offer once the timer runs out. If we're using you know, something called Deadline Funnel, we'll auto switch the offer and boom, you've got a new offer for anybody that missed that. Now we have a Cyber Monday. And we run that till about Wednesday.
Mm-hmm.
So we're running marketing open cart with some type of offer for about 2 full weeks, whereas last year it was like 4 days, five days.
And even more important or equally as important as when that cart becomes available is the conditioning of the marketplace from you ahead of that.
Yes.
And this is probably why, you know, this is why we wanted to have this conversation with you guys today as opposed to early November, because start buttering everybody up, you know, making sure that your email, your hygiene. Exactly, right? Clean up those lists, make sure that you've got good value going out ahead of it. Don't start pitching people now. That's not the point, right? What we want to do is we want to get that engagement. We want to provide some value. Create an environment where people are going to be opening up your emails. I can guarantee, you know, the big box retailers are going to be doing the same thing. I wouldn't doubt that they're already starting to hit your inbox as far as what to expect come Black Friday.
Mm-hmm.
And it's going to happen, if not, you know, like this week, in the next coming weeks.
Yeah. At least by Halloween it'll be out.
Oh, absolutely. I'm sure.
So what Randy's saying is we can't just wait until the Black Friday pitch and just start emailing your list that day.
Especially with just offers.
We're telling you to send out content, and we've talked to many episodes about content. Give value. Let's talk about what you can do up until Black Friday about, you know, some good content you can write. So Halloween's coming up, so, right? You can talk about what, you know, eat this, not that,
yeah.
Right? Pick this, not that. You can talk about surviving the holidays. You can talk about fall weather type of activities outdoors. Stuff like that is what we're talking about. Get the emails out. Start posting about it, not the Black Friday sale, guys. That's not what we're talking about. We're talking about the content to get people looking forward to seeing emails coming in your inbox. Okay,
exactly. You're conditioning.
And if you continue to email bad contacts, it's only going to get worse when you start continuing to email more and more people. So if you haven't gone back to our episode with Evan Samarin,
36 or 44, somewhere in there. We just talked about it recently. I'll have it in the show notes. I'll put it in the show notes.
Yeah, let's get you, go listen to that email deliverability podcast with Evan. Shoot, I wish we had it up. Okay, well, we'll put in the show notes. Mm-hmm. Check it out there. There's a lot of steps that you're going to want to take ahead of this, but we want you to be prepared, okay? And typically the way we run our Black Friday campaigns is, Big buildup, big engagement back and forth through email. This year, we're going to be adding text and voicemails, and we're also going to basically offer a good, better, best. We like the paid in full because this is be about the only time somebody's going to take out their credit card and spend $3,000, $4,000, $5,000 online without ever coming in. Now, you will get a lot of people that want to come in to the gym and purchase that. No problem. You're going to have to be available. And maybe you email back and forth and say, hey, I'm out of town. When I get back in on Monday, I'll lock you in on that deal. But it's done in person. We sold a bunch of stuff in person, yeah, by the way. That's the question. Like, does it all have to happen online? The answer is no, but you need to get a commitment online.
And what we talked about, or I know you and I have talked, I think we were talking about yesterday when we were planning the Black Friday stuff for ourselves and the workshop and stuff, you have to be prepared for to do the work. You know what I mean? Don't expect everything just flip a switch and then all of a sudden an online system does 100% of it, guys. This is your opportunity to make. I mean, you want to talk some numbers of years past? I mean, you just gathered some of them, right?
I just posted it. Yeah. So I think I posted like five or six client results. It was $8,800. It was $24,000. It was $32,000. It was $29,000. $41,000 collected cash in the bank. $41,000
in a weekend, guys.
Yep.
And now we're going to be doing this for hopefully or roughly 10 days or so.
Yep.
I mean, think about the potential revenue. If you're coming out of COVID where, you know, cash flow is tight, how many, you know, of you guys are, you know, many gyms are still on the cusp of keeping the doors open and closing the doors. This could save your business.
Yeah, we're talking $25,000, $30,000, $40,000 in cash in your bank coming out of Black Friday that you start, you know, like you starting December with that in the bank.
Yeah, that's a heck of a cash reserve to just, you know, come out of nowhere. And granted, you're selling something, right? You've got clients you're going to be servicing in exchange for this the value and the money. But at the end of the day, that's the reason we're in business. So if they want to buy online or if they want to come in and sit with you or tour the gym, do the work. Mm-hmm. Give them the opportunity, guys. This is going to be huge.
Yep. And we're going to give you guys some great resources in the Black Friday campaign with us. When you sit with me on that Zoom, we're going to build this out together. I'm going to show you who clicked on the emails, who's a buyer, who's not a buyer, somebody that's thinking on it about it, and give you all their information so you can actually pick up the phone and call them to try to close even more deals. All of the deals that were made last year, those numbers I just shared with you, they were done via email.
Yes.
We're not spending Facebook money because the environment of Facebook during Black Friday week is insane. Your Absolutely. CPMs are through the roof. Like we said, every retailer in there, everybody's advertising.
Guys, you don't want to be competing against a Walmart when it comes to advertising dollars on Facebook right now or, you know, during that time. Mm-hmm. They have deeper pockets, you know, and they can't outspend us.
So let's stay away from that.
Yeah.
And let's stick to the conversations via email, text, and voicemail. I think we beat them that way.
Absolutely.
So you're probably thinking, okay, so how many people should I have on my list? And how many, you know, what should I be doing? I think it's in everybody's best interest all year long to collect leads, but let's collect more now. If you can give away lead magnets mm-hmm. or things to collect emails to get people on your list now, all the better. But I will tell you, we had Thomas did just under 10,000 last year with 120 emails.
Yeah.
120 emails.
It's amazing.
He made 10 grand, just about 10,000. So it does. You don't need to have a huge list as long as you have a relationship with the list.
Correct.
If you're not, you know, kind of nurturing them now and they don't know who you are, it's probably not going to work for you because this isn't a slam dunk. It will work as long as you've got the resources and tools to do it. So make sure, gather emails, get everybody in your database, start giving them great content now. And if you're ready for the Black Friday campaign, if you're ready to do this, we're doing something really crazy this year. We're actually going to have you only pay us the second half if you're satisfied. So if you're interested in this, the whole thing's $2,500, okay? You're going to only pay $1,500 to register and only will be billed the other portion of that if you're satisfied. If you're not satisfied, we won't bill you. But I think you will be.
Yeah.
I think you're going to make a ton of money. And at the end of the day, you're going to have this campaign in your account. You're going to learn how we structured it. You can use it again next year, or you can mimic other. We've had people use that campaign and created anniversary flash sales.
Birthday
sales. Flash sales.
Yep.
It's the same style of campaign, just with more nuts and bolts in it because of the text messaging and everything we're doing this year. It's gonna crush. And so, guys, you're absolutely crazy if you're not doing anything for Black Friday at this level. Don't expect to throw a couple emails out and not have a way for somebody to purchase and expect to make, you know, to make any money. A Facebook post ain't gonna cut it this year.
Nope.
We've got a whole strategy that builds up the sell, the anticipation, the timers, the open cart, the closed cart, the deadlines. All of this is built into this. That's good, better, best. Clicks, redirects, you know, all kinds of cool stuff we're going to build into this campaign. I'm going to build it for you or build it ahead of time, and I'm going to give it to you, and we're going to connect it all together online.
What more could you want?
I don't know. We're giving you money, guys. We're giving you money. If you want it, how do they get in this workshop?
pfmarketingsolutions.com/Black Friday.
Black Friday. Okay. By the time this comes out, we'll have something there for you to register on.
Yeah.
But this is fresh off the press. We knew we were going to do a Black Friday, but I think it's important to talk about it really far in advance this year, just because we're up against, you know, people are so used to shopping online right now that, you know, these retailers know that, and they're going to be attacking. They're attacking. And we're up against everybody, right? Mm-hmm. You know, there's only so many dollars in the market to spend. And so let's hopefully they spend them with you and not, you know, Best Buy or,
yeah,
you know, Kohl's this year.
Yeah, how about it? And guys, I mean, understand, you know, the message that we've carried across here is imperative for every gym. We suggest using Keep. We suggest coming to our workshop, sitting in that seat, because this is a system that we've used over and over and over and over again. We've done this over the last few years. We've passed this on to our clients over the last few years. You heard the success of each of those clients. That's why we're willing to put some of our income at stake, so that you can try it, see it for yourself, experience it, win, and then you're going to be happy cutting us that next check. Think
yeah.
about that.
You can't wait to, yeah, exactly. And to your point, Randy, we've perfected this Black Friday. We've ran this. This will be our fifth year in a row mm-hmm. running this. The least we've made was 20,000. Okay. The most we've made, I think, was like 47,000, 48,000. And we went even lazier. We just did it all on email, and we didn't do any, everything was purchased online. I was in California spending time with the family, and I'm just watching my phone. Ping, ping, ping. It's a great feeling. If you've never sold anything online through automation, a whole world's going to open up for you guys once yeah. you start seeing this happen. I mean, you're just going to have like, where are these people coming from? They're giving me money.
It's addicting in a way.
Yeah.
It is such a, yeah, like a satisfying feeling. Like it's yeah. like crack. You want more, you know? It's just like, yeah, as those emails come in, as the notifications go off, it is such a fun
it's
feeling.
I don't know. I kind of relate it to like a video game.
Mm-hmm.
When we look at the campaign reporting and you see the people flowing through, and like the, you know, 5,000 people went in over here, 1,000 of them clicked on this, 25 of these people went over here and bought this, and 25 bought that.
Here in abandoned carts, they're coming back, they're gonna be emailed, those sales goes off. All that stuff is just so much fun.
Super cool. We're nerdy about it, but at the end of the day, it's going to result in new people into your gym and money in your bank. What else can you really ask for when it comes to marketing?
It's business.
Jump on at pfmarketingsolutions.com/Black Friday. Get prepared. It's early October right now, but it's never too early to be prepared for mm-hmm. this particular campaign. And we've got your solution for you in that workshop. Only pay a portion up front. Pay the rest if you're satisfied, guys. That's it for this episode. We'll see you on the next show. Bye.